Hey guys, it's me again, Jackie. I wanted to get back with you because I didn't have enough time in the first video to cover the rest of it, and I want to get right into shelters, okay? Shelters are things that are going to keep you warm and dry and safe against animals and whatnot. If you happen to be stuck out in an area, a desert area or something like that, and there's creosote available, you know, like those plants that have creosote, maybe I'll attach a picture at the end of this to show you what creosote looks like. Bugs and animals alike cannot stand the smell. So if you find a little den somewhere and you want to seek shelter in there, maybe possibly there was a mountain lion there before or something else, you can line the outside of your den with that. And they won't come near you because they can't stand the smell of it. Now, the biggest thing also, if you decide to build a fire while you're out there, do not use the creosote bush because it emits this gas that can actually make you pass out. It's very toxic to you. All right. Now, this one is on shelters, how to construct them. It covers wigwams. The Indians were smart. Tells you how to create wigwams. Lean-to shelters, snow caves if you happen to be in the snow, a snow hole, snow pit, a snow house with snow block walls. Okay, and urban areas. Here's the question that's been, people been asking me left and right, what you can do in urban areas. So I'm just going to read it because I haven't even touched on this subject. So it's urban areas. Survivability of operating in an urban area depends on your ability to locate adequate positions and protective positions from the many apparent covered and concealed areas available. Remember, we covered covered and concealed positions earlier. I'm not going to get into that. Urban structures are the most advantageous locations for you to position yourself. You can also look up the Field Manual 90-10. It contains detailed information on urban terrain operations. That is FM 90-10. That contains detailed information on urban terrain operations and survivability in an urban environment. All right, let's get into below ground structures. Below ground structures talks about detailed knowledge of the nature and location of below ground facilities and structures. Obviously, that's a great area. If you're in an urban area and you've got a subway system down below, that's excellent protection for you. At least for a moment, you know, just for a while until you can find your way out to another secure location. But if I was in an urban environment, that's where I would go. I'd find something underground that's going to be underground. Anything with thick walls, deeply recessed windows. You want to find a place with few, if any, windows if you happen to be above ground, okay? This book is outstanding. I can't quit praising it, and I can't quit praising Jesus for sending me here to this so I can get this to you. I'm imagining that's what he wanted me to do, but because since I opened this book, I've had you guys in mind. I haven't been able to get it out of my head about posting a video about this book. And it is, again, in case you missed the first video, a book on survivability. Okay? That's the FM5-103. You Google it and you can download it. Okay, guys? It's excellent. Alright. Another part of this book that I want to talk about was towards the end, okay, in Appendix C, okay. It covers everything that you could possibly build out there, how to construct it, what it's defensible against. And the best part I like about it, let me find a good one, precast concrete, covered deep cut positions, soldier stuff. All right, this is exactly what I wanted to show you too. Hardened frame fabric shelters, okay? In the back, in this appendix, see, all right? These are your plans on how to build it, all right? This is page 1 of 3. If you keep going and you get to page 2, It covers more plans. Okay? And the very best item, very best thing in this whole book, is on page 3. This right here, see if I can see it. This one here gives you, right here, a list of everything you need to build it. To include hinge butt steel, metal sheet, steel angle, pipe steel. It just covers how many feet and the quantity that you need. So, if anybody's in any kind of engineering field, then you'll understand this is a bill of materials. And it lists everything in the quantity you need. Now, there's another area in here that tells you that it's excellent for protecting you against nuclear activity. But it also tells you how many hours it takes to build it. So, I mean, I can tell you now, I think it's 45 man-hours to build it. If you don't understand man-hours, let's say I got 6 people working in one day, 8 hours a day, it's 48 man-hours. It takes 45 construction time man-hours to build this using a hand tools and a backhoe. It will protect you against medium artillery no closer than 10 feet, and this shelter provides excellent provides improved nuclear protection up to 30 psi. And out of everything that's in this manual, that's the only one that provides that amount of protection against that any type of nuclear activity that we could see here. So if it can provide protection against nuclear activity, then everything else that could be coming against you later is going to be of a less degree than the nuclear activity itself. So it's great. I highly recommend you download this. It covers so much stuff. I'll keep you guys posted if I find out anything else that might be pertinent to our escape and evade, to our cause, to the Patriot Movement. I will definitely post it. Okay? And God bless you all, and thank you for watching my video. If you've got anything else you would like me to talk about, as soon as I get the items, I can demonstrate things like how to start a fire, you know, without matches, and some expedient fire starting stuff as cheap as $3 that you could buy. So I can go into that as well. All you need is a cotton ball, some Vaseline, and some plastic baggies. You dip the cotton ball into the Vaseline, and you load a plastic baggie with about 6 or 7 of them, and they burn hot and they burn long. So that's once you've got your fire, you know, you can start it without it. I'll teach you guys all that stuff later on, but I definitely wanted to get this out to you tonight. It's getting late, North Dakota time. Hopefully it won't snow. Anyways, God bless you guys. Good night. Love you all.